closer to daycare. My sister's to school, taking myself to my school, my class. So, as a young woman, I always wanted something more. I always knew it was something more for me in life. So I was always trying to, like, figure out how to, like, remove it through life. So I started out early working on my credit and trying to save a little bit. Not much, but trying to save. And I started out, like, knowing that I had to do something. And then for somebody to come along after years of hard work, trying to, like, just steal my profile and then mess me up. Oh, this last time, y'all, I think they tried to destroy your girl's spirit, but God was not having it. God was not having it. Do you hear me? Shoot. I already came back from being successful in business and then losing everything and then getting sued a couple of times and end up having to file bankruptcy from, you know, sued from the corporations that I was in partnership with as far as the business, like a florist or whatever, because of my freaking landlord wouldn't resign my lease, you know what I'm saying? After I done built up the location, now he wanted it back. He could sell it for more than what it was worth, you know what I'm saying? And of course, I didn't have the money, so he couldn't sell it to me. You know, I'm not his child, not his family. Don't you? I built it up and he said, oh, this is my chance to get what I need, you know. So, yeah, he got rid of the place and threw me out with it, with my kids and my employees, my business, everything. I had to file bankruptcy. And then I get down here to Texas, become who I am, worked on myself. Even before I came on, who I am, I was working on myself. And then get to the point where I literally have great, excellent across the board. And then somebody come along So I'm going to tell you what happened. They end up sending it to the collection. And child, that thing hit my credit report. Oh my gosh. I was affected so badly. I'm telling you, I had with one company, I had almost $7,000 in credit debt. I only use when I go to the dentist and stuff like that or the doctor. Child, they hurt and snatched that credit from me. They took it. I couldn't believe it. As a matter of fact, one time I used the whole $7,000 and I paid it back. And I had $7,000 and something dollars in credit so that I could be able to like have finances when I need it. Child, they snatched it so fast. I didn't know what was going on. And my credit score went down like, and then another credit company said because of, I don't know how they said it, but resources or something from other companies that basically I wasn't even allowed to use my credit. And I had like $2,000 with that company. I think $2,500. They locked it. And I'm just like, wait a minute, what's going on? And y'all, when I called, oh my God, y'all, they put the hound on me. They got a hound that they hires to be ready to right at you when you call. Child, I call, I say, hi, my name is because, of course, you know, they don't open up bank accounts. They done did a whole lot of stuff, y'all. I ain't even gonna get into every little thing right now, because that ain't even the point. Because today, spirit has been vindicated. Oh my goodness, I woke up this morning. See, my credit petition people already told me that they was not going to let that affect me, because when, from the investigation, whoever did that, that was not me at all. Because where they lived at, zip code, all the information they gave led to someone else, but not me. And they're going to make sure it's removed from my credit report, but I still was dealing with like the credit people, like credit card people, even though like my credit protection protected me. It was the credit card companies that now treat me like I did something, because they all connected. DirecTV mad because they not getting paid, and then they mad because I'm not willing to lie down and say, okay, I'll take the blame for something. My credit be okay, so I'ma go ahead and pay it. No, because I ain't got that kind of money. If I ain't got cable and I ain't watching cable, then I'm gonna, if I'm gonna pay for somebody else to watch it. Are you serious? No. So yeah, I did what I had to do. I went to the police. I filed a report. I filed a report on all of them. Whoever filed the address, the phone number, everything that I can get. The what you gonna collection agency, I filed a report on DirecTV, all of them. Everybody, I was not playing. I was like, y'all not gonna be sitting up here destroying my life, and I'm supposed to be okay with it. You know what I'm saying? And y'all, when I talked to DirecTV, they basically didn't even want to talk to me. They was like, well, send in a police report before they even can discuss with me about the account. Child. So I did that like like a month ago. And then this morning I woke up and they said upon the report and their investigations that they did, that they find that is not liable for any criminal activity, any fraud, or any bill, or anything that was put in my name in a fraudulent way, and used my social in a fraudulent way. And they said they found credible evidence that it was not me. Sent me an apology and let me know that they contact the credit protection people and they contact the collection agencies and told them to remove my name from being responsible for that bill. It is not my responsibility and I am not liable for it. And they said they contact the credit bureau too to let them know. Just like, I know the freak that's right. I know the freak that's right. Yes, y'all girl has been vindicated. Like, what the freak? Shoot. Messing with your girl's spirit like that. Shoot. But we won't let nothing. because I've been going through it. Not only have I been going through, like, being disappointed by this, this so-called relationship I was supposed to be in, I was so disappointed with that. And then dealing with this, oh my God, just being let down over and over again, back to back, by bullish. But I did give it a good long enough time to know that I know for a fact that I made the right decision. Now, you want me to sit up here and say, he deserve a good woman, it's just not me? No. He don't deserve no good woman. No good woman. He ain't ready for no good woman. And instead of praying for him, I pray for all the women that cross his path. That God cover them and keep them in. That they don't get caught up in his web. That's why I say don't give up on yourself. No matter how bad and how gloomy things may look, you believe in yourself. It's going to work its way out. Cause me to wake up this morning and be vindicated, I didn't see that. I didn't think they would ever like send me a letter, an apology, and actually take action to reverse what they did. Like, what the freak? Spirit girl, still here. I'm still making it work. I'm still doing what I gotta do. I don't know why that had to happen to me, but it did. Ever since my license got stolen, and she was telling me just didn't make sense. It didn't make sense, so I had to ask a lot of questions. Do what I can. credit staying locked. Like everything else, it's locked and nobody getting up in here. Nobody. Experiences in life that when they know they met a good person, that a person that would be there for them and had their back, that they would have it together. You know what I'm saying? You would think they would know that and they would do everything they can to make sure, like, they continue having this person in their life. But some people just, I don't know. I'm just saying some people, I don't even want to say some people don't grow up. I'm so trusting. I'm such a trusting person. Not anymore, though. Just not anymore, y'all. That's just the way it is. It's just, y'all, this stuff changes you. This crap that I've been through, I'm not that trusting person anymore. I'm just not. And then with this relationship stuff, no, I'm not going to trust like that, just like that. I just can't do it. Trust just like that anymore. It just ain't happening. I ain't even going to say it's going to take time. I'm just not going to do it. A person will have to prove themselves to me big time. It would take a lot for a person for me to trust anybody at this point. With my heart, as far as like a lover, you know what I mean? I'm not doing that. People just be out here lying, telling you don't even have to lie. They be out here lying, y'all. Just lying. Oh my God. Lying to people. But, I don't even believe, like, I'm not going to say that the guy that I was dating wasn't seeing somebody else. He probably was. I'm not going to say that. I believe it, though. But I'm going to tell y'all something. I know exactly what he was doing. And I'm going to tell y'all about it one of these days. I am. I just don't like talking about it right now. Because then I'll be pissed off and I'm trying to stay in a good mood. I don't know what made me think that I could actually date somebody and it was going to actually see me. They was going to actually see me for who I really am and actually enjoy the spirit experience. that they could actually like really conversate with me and actually live their life with me and it be real, you know what I'm saying? But I'm realizing that, no, the reality is I'm spirit. I'm spirit, girl. I'm ASMR to you. But it would have been nice. It would have been so nice. Oh my God, I was looking so forward to really growing old with somebody. I was just looking so forward to it. Even doing the things of helping each other as we get older that we couldn't do when we were younger. You know what I'm saying? I was looking forward to it. Celebrating special things and little things with somebody. is good because I feel like I didn't do that the other day. I'm out of practice, y'all. It's been a while. I'm sorry if y'all hear my stomach growling. I'm hungry. That's why I don't want to chew gum, because if I chew gum, it's just going to make it worse. People so quick to judge you, especially like when it, like, you know, oh my god, with this credit stuff, like, you're sitting there explaining to them that it's not you, you didn't do this, but they don't see it like that, they see it as you did it, so they like the way they treat you and the stuff they put you through, you know, it make you feel so bad, oh my gosh. Somebody say, no, I can't have something because of the fraud alert and the stuff that's on my credit. Oh my God, just was like gut wrenching, especially when I always get a yes. And then I'm just like, oh my God, this is so embarrassing. So to wake up and to see, oh my God, vindication is nothing other than God. I just feel like what I've been dealing with, for that's what it is. For 2023, I was dealing with deceit, dishonesty, betrayal, and fraud in my personal life with the relationship. That's what I was dealing with all 2023 and coming into 2024. Yeah, your girl deserved this good news today. I deserve that for real. I'm gonna use some dark powder too on top of it to get everything to come back good. Don't you let nothing stand in your way. I want y'all to listen. Every word I say, oh man, my stomach is just like, girl, I think my stomach is like a mill. Inside my stomach is like a mill. He's definitely not ladylike. Thank you. to start working it. Put the powder on first. I feel so much better. I feel like it's really a black lip liner, but I'm using it as an eyeliner. It's pretty. Thank you. But it's not that light. It's not going to be like the green, green color. I'm going to use it as the base. I feel like it's going to be pretty. It's that color that said, I don't need no permission. It's that color that said, healing power. I know that freak, that's right. And then I found this other color. This brush might be too big. Oof, I gotta get me some makeup brushes. Okay, we're gonna use that pretty color I told y'all about. I want to just keep it like this, but the green is not going to be the showstopper. It's the show starter. Period. because that's so fly. We're polishing. We're getting ourselves together. We're polishing up by act now. And if you've been held down before, I know you refuse to be held down anymore. Because it looked like the same color that I just put on, but the color that I put on got like a more bright of a light to it, and that's what I wanted. And this one right here is darker. Shame. down. And now all we gotta do is put on the lipstick. So I'm gonna go with the rouge like I went the other day, but I'm not gonna. Today, I hope you enjoyed the video, and thank you everybody who supported my GoFundMe. Your girl appreciate it so much. Thank you so much. I'm definitely using every penny, and every penny is needed. I still gotta get a lens and I need a new camera, and I'm just praying that my camera can just hold up until I can get a new one. Okay, we're gonna use this Lancome. This is the Lancome lipstick. Absolutely gorgeous. I felt like I touched the bottom of my teeth. It's one of my outfits that, you know, you and your lover meeting up for like a Friday night, and y'all had a long week, but now y'all get ready to have a romantic night, and he bringing some wine, and you done cook the, I would say for me, the lobster. You done cook some lobster and some rice and a side salad, and he coming with the wine, and then he ring the doorbell, ding dong, you like, hello. Who's there? Oh, okay. Come on up. Stop playing with me. Okay, anyway, that's one of them sexy, oh girl. This one of them sexy, pretty looks. I love it. Okay, so let me do the finish look for y'all. This spear grass out of here. Have a wonderful day, afternoon, and night, and I will see y'all in the next video. I gotta go clean up my nails, add a nail here and there. I think I got two nails missing right here.